Hey guys, it's Daniel. I'm the founder and owner of Skamidan, skating school and skate shop in Wein am Rhein, Germany. Well, in recent years I used many different protectors for skating, and today I will show you which protectors I prefer and why I prefer those. Afterwards, I will also show you which protectors I've ever used. And lastly, we will take a detailed look at protectors in general and what makes a protector a good protector for you. Let's start with the most important protection. This is a skate helmet. Sure, it's not often that somebody falls on his head, and many people have never fallen on their head. Nevertheless, there is no more important protection than the skate helmet. So we don't use knee pads, then it can only happen that we will break our knee. That's already bad enough, because it will hurt and we want to be able to skate for a few months. But should we fall onto our head without wearing a helmet, then it can happen that we can never skate again. Or worse, we can have lifelong disabilities. So what is more uncool? Wearing protectors? Or maybe not to be able to skate for a long time? Well, that's your choice. Please also keep in mind that not always you are the cause of an accident. Also others can cause your fall. No matter if you are a beginner, an advanced or a pro skater, a good protection gear is always important. I myself witnessed how a helmet protected a boy from a deadly accident. So please guys, I know it's uncomfortable, but it's extremely important. Okay, here you can see that my helmet is shaking around a little, but in the best case the helmet fits perfectly. However, all manufacturers known to me only offers helmets in a certain size range. For example, one size with a range of 54 to 58 cm or 58 to 62 cm. I think manufacturers should offer more different sizes. For example, one extra size for each 2 cm. To find the best fitting helmet, just measure your head circumference and choose the right size using the dealer's size table. At the latest, when we are planning to go to the skate park or start doing tricks, we should get a skate helmet. And for more comfort, the skate helmet should be equipped with a cushion. Let's take a look at a second and most useful part of protection gear, the knee pads. They are needed to be able to fall precisely and safely in almost every situation. But knee pads and other pads aren't all equal. There are significant differences. I recommend the use of knee pads with a cover for your knees and a big plastic cap. For example, those kind of protectors are made from Powerslide or Inri. Instead of those, I also recommend protectors like the protectors I almost always use. These protectors are from the brand Inri. They are extremely light and very flexible. For me, it feels like wearing leggings. And no, I'm sorry I don't wear leggings, but I'm sure it feels the same. There are currently two different variants of these protectors. There is a pro and a non-pro version. The non-pro version is as good as identical to the G-Form protectors, which you can see here. These were also the first protectors of this kind I ever had. G-Form as well as the non-pro annual protectors are very soft, but in case of a crash or an impact, they will become extremely hard. That's the reason why they are very comfortable and safe as well. Basically, these are already top protectors, but with two small disadvantages. First, the elastic stocking gives way after some time. The protector no longer offers 100% support and can slip a little. This can be prevented by using a simple strap in the lower part of the protectors, but it's not cool. The second disadvantage mainly concerns aggressive inline skating. The material is comparatively thin and it can hurt when you slip out of a grind and bang against the edge. And that's the reason why, since half a year, I no longer use the G-Form protectors. For 6 months, I use the ANU Pro knee gaskets. These are almost as comfortable as the G-Form or non-pro ANU protectors, and after a few minutes on skates, you won't notice them anymore. In addition, the protection is much better. It doesn't and won't hurt if you hit an edge. Moreover, they are more durable. The stocking is also elastic, but by slightly sweating, it contracts and ensures optimal hold. I know those protectors are very expensive, so when the comfort is not the most important thing for you, there are more than enough and cheaper protectors, which also ensure good protection. Well, for both kinds of protecting gear, it's very important that they fit perfectly. In case of a fall, crash or impact, they shouldn't be able to move or slip off of the body part to be protected. For that reason, I highly recommend protectors and pads with a stretchable stocking or sleeve with one or two straps. Unfortunately, many local stores just have useless protectors, but maybe you're one of the happy guys which have a good local dealer. Lastly, there is one important difference between the kind of G-Form or ANU gaskets, protectors and others. The protectors with a plastic cap or plate have a shock absorber between your body and the cap or plate, so they are much better to be safe in case of a high vertical drop, like skating on a real half pipe, vert ramp or other high vertical obstacle. I think you should use protectors with a plastic cap or plate and padding for high vert ramps. But in my experience, ANU Pro gaskets are also good to be safe while skating a vert ramp. However, in case of a vertical drop onto the flat, it will hurt anyway. So believe me, you will miss the shock absorbers. And this also applies to the elbow pads. The third most important pads are the hand protectors, or better, complete wrist guards. In most cases, hand protectors, like the protectors which you can see here, are sufficient. They will protect you from abrasions or lacerations, but when you want to be protected against bone fractures, like a wrist fracture, you should use complete wrist guards. Good, wrist guards have two protective plates, a plate on the top and one on the bottom. My favorite wrist guards are the ANU City Brace. Here, the protective plates are completely sawn, so they are very durable. Moreover, I really like the neoprene gloves in the inner. They make these wrist guards very comfy and you will fall as softly as possible. In addition, when skating in winter, the neoprene gloves protect against cold. Yes, I know in summer it gets very warm, but no matter which wrist guards you will wear, I think you will sweat anyway. Lastly, the ANU City Braces have a super closure system, which does not open unintentionally. And these were all usual protectors. If you like to be safer, you may also use other protectors like shin guards, protective pants, crash pads or ankle footies. If you slip off of a lip trick or grind or just miss your grind, shin guards can be very helpful to save you from intense pain. That's the reason why I always use shin protectors. My favorite shin guards are the ANU Park shin guards. These have a great fit, provide reliable protection and can be easily deformed. Crash pads, for example, you may use for downhill skating or when you're trying or practicing new tricks like a 540 in a mini ramp or pipe. But I'm sure you will also find other possible use cases. Neoprene footies can be minimized the pressure on the ankles or can be used for a better fit in your skates. Especially if you have a narrow heel, they are super helpful. Together, with all mentioned protectors, we achieve a top protection. So, when we like to pursue our passion as long as possible, we should use them. To summarize, we can say that there are many different protectors for skating. Some are more comfortable, others provide a better protection in extreme situations, but each of us has his personal preferences and his own requirements for a good protector. However, no matter which protector you prefer and you will choose, it's always very important that they have a good fit. They shouldn't be able to slip. Therefore, please don't just buy any protectors to just have some. Choose the right protectors and make sure they cannot slip. Do you have the opportunity to buy your protectors in a local shop? Then go there and try as many protectors as possible to find the run that gives you the best protection. And I say this as the owner of a webshop, because the health of all of us is very important to me. I also love skating and want to be able to pursue this passion as long as possible. And I wish you the same. If you are local, you are welcome to visit us on request and try on various protectors. If there is no suitable local shop or does it not carry your desired products, you are also welcome to visit our webshop. Be sure to pay attention to the size charts or contact us for further information. I'm sure we will find the right protectors and sizes for you. Dear friends of the sun and skating, take care of you and stay healthy. We will see you in the next video. Cheers, yours Daniel.